स्टूडेंट्स, आई वेलकम यू ऑल एंड टुडे टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज हॉर्स शू किडनी. सो व्हाट हैपेंस, हाउ द हॉर्स शू किडनी इज फॉर्मड, वी विल डिस्कस नाउ. सो ड्यूरिंग द प्रीनेटल लाइफ, ड्यूरिंग द डेवलपमेंट, व्हेन द फीटस इज इनसाइड द मदर वूम, सो डेवलपमेंट इज गोइंग इनसाइड, द होल डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द ऑर्गन्स इज गोइंग इनसाइड. सो व्हाट हैपेंस, टू मेसोमेट्रिक बर्ड्स आर फॉर्मड, मेसोनेफ्रिक बर्ड्स आर फॉर्म्ड ऑन द वन साइड ऑफ द वर्टिकल कॉलम. सो दिस इज द वर्टिकल कॉलम. सो इन द वर्टिब्रम कॉलम on the either sides, on the each side, that is on the left and right, the two one mesonephric bird is formed on one side, so one in left and one in right. So two mesonephric birds are formed along the sides of the future vertebral column. Now what will happen, this mesonephric birds will develop and grow into metanephros. So these two mesonephric birds will grow into two metanephros. So this mesonephric birds will form ureter and kidney. So the pair of kidney, that are total two kidneys, one in left and one in right. So this kidney and ureter is formed of the two mesonephric birds, which are on the either side of the vertebral column, on left and right. Now what will happen, generally there is no fusion of the poles of the kidney. As we all know, kidney has a pole, upper pole and lower pole. Now these two kidneys are formed from the two mesonephric birds, but there is no fusion. But in case of horseshoe kidney, there will be collision of the lower pole. So here the fusion of the lower pole occurs. In generally the fusion occurs in the lower pole, but in rare cases the fusion can occur in the upper pole also. So if the fusion occurs in the upper poles of the kidney, then it is called reverse horseshoe kidney. Reverse horseshoe kidney when the fusion occurs in the upper pole. When the fusion occurs in the lower pole, it is called horseshoe kidney. So it is a congenital anomaly. Now the symptoms or the clinical features. In many cases, patient is asymptomatic. So patient has no symptoms. There is asymptomatic clinical, the patient is asymptomatic. But sometimes a palpable mass is felt, and that is felt in the lower umbilical region. Lower umbilical region. That is on the right and left side. So patient will say, or during the examination, doctor will felt a mass, a palpable mass is felt in the lower umbilical region in the left and right area. Because there is fusion of the lower poles of the kidney. Now, because there is fusion of the lower poles of the kidney, so ureters will ambulate. On isthmus, as we all know, there is isthmus, so ureters will ambulate on the isthmus, and there will be kicking, there will be pressure, congestion, and that will cause stasis. So that will result in stasis and infections. So there is recurrent infections because of the stasis of urine because of the stasis and obstruction of the urine or the stasis to the flow of the urine that will result in recurrent infections. And that recurrent infections will later on result in stone formation. So the stone formation will occur in the ureters because of the angulation of the ureters on isthmus. Then there could be hydronephrosis. Hydronephrosis is when the kidney will increase in size because of the stasis. Hydronephrosis. So dilated kidney because of the obstruction and stasis that will result in hydronephrosis of the kidney. Then there is Rofsing sign, that is the confirmatory sign. Rofsing sign. So when the spine is hyper extended, so that will cause nausea and vomiting. Because of the angulation of the ureters, that will cause nausea and vomiting on the hyperextension of spine. This is the Rofsing sign. So in clinical features, in many patients, the case is asymptomatic. There is lower umbilical palpable mass felt in the right and left regions. Then because of the ureters angulation, there will be recurrent infection and could be stone formation, and in chronic cases there could be hydronephrosis. In investigations, because if there is any infection, then we will go for the urine culture if there are features accompanying like fever, chills, rigor, body ache, malaise, then this indicates that there is some infection. So then we will go for the urine culture to detect which is the causative organism, and depending on that organism we will prescribe the medication. The antibiotics will be given on the basis of the organism which has caused the infection. And if there is stone or hydronephrosis or any other complication, and to visualize, to see whether the cause is because horseshoe kidney, because of the fusion of the lower poles, so we have to go by imaging techniques. So we recommend patient for ultrasonography, so that will detect the anomaly. Then isotope. Isotope Reno. Isotope Renogram. Then we will also do CT scan. So CT scan and ultrasound will ultrasonography will detect the horseshoe kidney. In treatment, there is no treatment or any surgical procedure to correct this structure. But if there is hydronephrosis or if there is stones, then we will take out the stones, we will basket out the stones. If there is an infection, tumor, then we will treat the complication. So there is no specific treatment for the horseshoe kidney, but if any complication is present like infections or hydronephrosis, if there is stasis, obstruction, stone, then we will treat accordingly.